So, good morning students. In the previous lecture, we have derived this expression in case of Hartley oscillator while discussing the equivalent circuit of Hartley oscillator, and we named this equation as equation number 10th. So, now put the values of Z1, Z2, Z3 in this expression number 10th. So, what was the value of Z1? Z1, it was the impedance of L1. Which is j omega L1 plus j omega M, which we have already defined in the beginning. Z2 is j omega L2 plus j omega M is equal to HIE. The value of Z1 is this, the value of Z2 is this, plus the value of Z3 is this, then plus the value of Z1, the value of Z2 and value of Z3. So now, as you can see from this first bracket, j omega is common, so take it common. From the second bracket, again j omega is common, so take it common. Now solve this. So here HIE, j omega L1 plus j omega M plus j omega L2 plus j omega M. Now rationalize this, it will be j upon j square. J square is actually iota square, which is equal to minus 1. So here we will have minus j upon omega c1 after rationalizing. And from this whole bracket, again we have to take j omega common because it is there in all the terms. But here in this term, there is no omega in the numerator. So to take this j omega common, what we will do, we will multiply and divide by omega. So in the denominator, we will have omega into omega, omega square. Plus, from this bracket, you can take again j omega common. So L1 plus M. And again here, j omega L1 plus j L2 j omega M, and again here rationalize it, you will have j upon j square. J square is minus 1, so minus j upon omega c1, and again from this bracket you have to take j omega common, but you can only take this j omega common if we have this omega in the numerator. So for that, multiply and divide by omega, and omega into omega here you will have omega square. So now we have this j into j will be j square, which is minus. So minus HFE, omega into omega will be omega square, L1 plus M into L2 plus M, it is equal to HIE. Now take j omega common from this first term, and inside the bracket you will have L1, and here M plus M will be 2M. L1 plus L2 plus 2M minus 1 by omega square C1. And here from this term take this j omega common. Again that j and this j, it will be j square, which is minus 1. Omega and that omega will be omega square into L1 plus M. And here we will have L2 plus M minus 1 by omega square C1. And suppose this equation as equation number 11th. Now from this equation, as we have to derive, number one is criteria for the sustained oscillations, and number two is frequency of the oscillations produced. Means we have to find out the value of omega and one criteria of sustained oscillations in case of Hartley oscillator. So what we will do now to solve this equation? As it contains j, or you can say that iota, it means it is a complex equation. So now we will compare real and imaginary parts on the both sides. So comparing, the real parts on the both sides or comparing the imaginary parts on the both sides. So first we will compare the imaginary parts. You can also compare real parts first. So comparing the imaginary parts on the both sides, as you can see on left hand side there is no imaginary part. So imaginary part on left hand side is 0. And what is the imaginary part on right hand side, coefficient of j cap on right hand side? It is this hie omega and this part. So as you can see on left hand side imaginary part is 0. It is equal to on right hand side the coefficient of j cap is hie omega L1 plus L2 plus 2m minus 1 by omega square C1. So hie omega, take it to left hand side, 0 divided by this will be 0. So we have L1 plus L2 plus 2m minus 1 by omega square C1, it is equal to 0. Now move this term to the other side because we have to calculate omega. So we have minus 1 by omega square C1, it is equal to minus L1 plus L2 plus 2m. This negative and negative sign will be cancelled out. Now move this C1 to this side and you will get 1 upon omega square, it is equal to C1 into L1 plus L2 plus 2m. Because we have to calculate the value of omega, now take its reciprocal. Taking reciprocal, we will have omega square is equal to 1 upon C1 into L1 plus L2 plus 2m. So the value of omega will be 1 upon root C1 into L1 plus L2 plus 2m. So this is the angular frequency of oscillations in case of Hartley oscillator. And to calculate the frequency of oscillations, that is f, we know that f, it is equal to omega by 2 pi. So the frequency of oscillations in case of Hartley oscillator will be 1 by 2 pi root C1 into L1 plus L2 plus 2m. So this is the frequency of oscillations produced in Hartley oscillator. Now we have to derive that what is the Barkhausen criteria of sustained oscillations in this case. For that, compare the real parts on both sides. Comparing real parts on both sides of equation 11. So we get the real part on left hand side is this. So minus HFE omega square L1 plus M into L2 plus M, and it is equal to the real part on right hand side is this. Minus omega square into L1 plus M into L2 plus M minus 1 by omega square C1. So negative sign will be cancelled out on both sides. Omega square will be cancelled out on both sides. L1 plus M will be cancelled out on both sides. So now move this L2 plus M to this side. On this side it was multiplied with this HFE, so on the other side it will be divided, so it will be in the denominator. And here we have L2 plus M minus, what is the value of 1 upon omega square C1? So while comparing the imaginary parts, we have already solved the value for 1 by omega square C1, which is L1 plus L2 plus 2M. So put this value of 1 by omega square C1 is equal to this in that equation. So here we will have L1 plus L2 plus 2m. Now solve this. एच एफ ई इट इज इक्वल टू 1 upon L2 plus M एंड हेयर L2 plus M माइनस L1 माइनस L2 एंड माइनस 2M. सो दिस विल बी कैंसल्ड आउट माइनस 2M एंड M इट विल बी प्लस माइनस एम. सो हेयर वी विल हैव माइनस L1 माइनस M. सो टेक माइनस कॉमन एंड हेयर वी विल हैव L1 प्लस M अपॉन L2 प्लस M. सो दिस इज द क्राइटेरिया फॉर सस्टेन्ड ऑसिलेशंस इन केस ऑफ हार्टली ऑसिलेटर. नाउ इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर we will discuss another important oscillator, that is Kolpit oscillator. And the difference of Kolpit oscillator from Hartley oscillator is that in the tank circuit, where in case of Hartley oscillator we were having the series combination of two inductors, in case of Kolpit oscillator we have the series combination of two capacitors C1 C2 in place of inductors L1 and L2. And then this series combination of two capacitors C1 and C2, it is combined in parallel with the inductor L1, where in case of Hartley oscillator, the series combination of two inductors L1, L2, it was connected in parallel to the capacitor C1. So the tank circuit is different here and all other everything is same.